In this video, we will be covering the first-person template included with Unreal Engine 4. Now, this template will provide you with a quick and easy way to get into a first-person game by giving you a first-person character movement, hands and weapon meshes, including skeletal animation for them, a working projectile weapon, a basic HUD with a crosshair, and a simple sound effect when firing. So let's go ahead and take a look. This is our first person project after we create it, and if we were to simply run this, we're going to find our basic first person that we would expect for a first person shooter. We can move around, we can look around, we can fire a weapon, we have some basic physics effects when we hit things with our projectile, and we can jump as needed. This pretty much is your basics for a first person shooter and starting out. Now, if we were to go ahead and spend a little bit of time and we were to actually go through some of the included learning resources, tutorial content, and other things, after a few hours, we might be able to create something like this. We'll go ahead and hit play. We have our weapon. We have a health bar on the bottom. If you didn't notice, I'll go ahead and play it again. We have a little objective that pops up at the top of the screen. We have a nice complete level that's running right here. We have some enemies in the screen. There's some trolls down there. If I have to shoot one, it'll come after me slowly. And if I shoot it enough times, it'll disappear in a puff of smoke. Now, these trolls also react not only based on being shot at, but vicinity. So you can see this one, when I got close enough, started pathing towards me. And it's using an AI NavMesh to look for the player. We can shoot it. It'll actually take more shots to destroy because everything was created individually. We could go over here, for example. We could have this one chase me and this one chase me. And you notice them path around using the appropriate spots. So like they may go up or down the stairs as needed to try to get to me. They can, of course, take different amounts of shots and explode independently. And like I mentioned earlier, we can actually trigger them from far away. Once we finish this up, once I manage to destroy the last one, we can create a little simple sequence where once we make it to the end of our ramparts, like we were instructed, it's going to go ahead and fly over our little parapet and give us a nice level complete screen. And that's it. That was created after a few hours using, again, included material from Unreal Engine in the marketplace, as well as the Learn tab and other external documents and resources. All of those resources will be included in the comment section or the included documentation with this video. So feel free to use this to make a nice first-person game really quickly and effectively.